compound inequalities, and between. With and, both equations must be true, meaning our solution has to be true for both. When we did or, notice that some of our solutions included ones that would not work from one equation or the other. But with and, it has to be true for both. So first we're going to float our answers, each part above the number line, and then we're going to use the overlap. Or in other words, the intersect. We're only going to have intersections with an and. So let's take a look at our first example here. So we solve. We get 6x is less than or equal to 11 minus 5, which would give us 6. Divide by 6. And x will be less than 1. Solving the other equation, we're going to subtract by 2. We get negative 7x is less than or equal to 22. Whoops. How about let's make that 42. And divide by negative 7. So we're going to get x is greater than or equal to a negative 6. So let's put those on the number line. Here's my negative 6, and here's my 1. Negative 6 is going to be a closed dot, and it says x is greater than or equal to negative 6, so that means it's going off to positive infinity. And for our 1, it's going to be an open dot, and it says x is less than 1. So that means it's going to be going off to negative infinity. Now, because both have to be true, we're only going to use the part where they overlap. So that means we're going to have a closed dot at negative 6, an open dot at 1, and our solution is going to be in between negative 6 and 1. So our interval notation then is going to be bracket negative 6, comma 1, parentheses. Let's take a look at example 2. I'm going to get my x's on one side. And we're going to have 8x minus 10 greater than negative 2. Add 10 to both sides. And we'll get 8x is greater than 8. Divide by 8. And we get that x is greater than or equal to 1, or not equal, sorry, just greater than 1. This one we need to distribute here. So we're going to get 10x minus 6 plus 2 greater than or equal to 18x minus 52. So we have 10x minus 4 greater than or equal to 18x. Minus 52. Let's get our variable on one side. And now have negative 8x minus 4 greater than or equal to negative 52. Add 4 to both sides. I have negative 8x greater than or equal to and negative 48, divide by negative 8, and so x is going to be less than or equal, remember we're divided by negative, a positive 6. Okay, let's take a look at our number line for this. I have 1 and 6. our 1's going to be an open dot. X is greater than 1, which just means it's going to positive infinity. We have a closed dot at 6, and x is less than or equal to 6, so that means it's going towards negative infinity. We're only going to want to graph the overlap, so that means we have an open dot at 1 and a closed dot at 6, and our graph is just going to be between 1 and 6. Interval notation is going to be from 1 to 6, starting with a parenthesis and ending with a bracket.